We have formed a dataset of over 1,240 WhatsApp forwards, and we have labeled them as fake and genuine messages. I'll start by showing you a copy pasting our WhatsApp forward which I received from my mom yesterday. Hydroxychloroquine is found in 100% in kalonji seed, and so to take 7 kalonji seed with honey and mix with water before breakfast will prevent us from COVID-19. So yes, our predictor predicted it as fake and showed the result over here. The next thing is, let's take some genuine news which we know is genuine. The news thing is open here. Let's type Punjab becomes the second state to extend the lockdown, and we click on submit. Yes, we know this is a genuine, and it showed the result as genuine message. We have tried to achieve an accuracy of 90% as seen here. We decided we divided the project into two to three parts, and that's how it took us 4 to 5 days to assign, like to do individually the each task, and then lastly we integrated all those stuff. The first thing was, since we decided that this thing can only happen with machine learning, so all of us were new to machine learning and we had very little or minimal experience with it. So we had to gain, like we had to first learn like what exactly we'll be doing. And for machine learning, the one thing which we needed was a data set, a good amount of data. We knew we had a collection of, we can have a genuine data of what the WhatsApp forwards are being done, which is the genuine data. We have got those data, but regarding the fake data, like whether this data is fake or not, we first ourselves had to know that it's a fake data. So for that purpose, spent a lot of time collecting and verifying the data, whether it is fake or not. In short, like the formation of the data set took a lot of time, and that was the most challenging task to do.
We requested all our friends to like forward us all the WhatsApp fake news, and many of them helped us, and that's how we prepared our data sets.
In our Somaya College, it's not only engineering campus, it's all science and commerce from management, and all from all over this campus we were getting congratulations, keep it up. And like in the same way, we like principal ma'am and all asked us to take the project forward and offered a mentor for us.
Actual process of learning keeps on going like that, right? So when we argue with each other or we hear each other's solutions, yeah, we find a better solution or a way out from there. It is good that if we learn when we have some prior targets, like whenever we started learning ML, so basically we had an idea about the project, like we have to make a fake news detector, and for that what things were required, and as per the requirements we started learning. And when we came through the challenges or when there were problems, we started searching to overcome them, and this way the learning happened. So basically, through a project, learning happens the best.
Actually, when we all started this, so for me, artificial intelligence was like some that people do after graduation in their PhD or something. So, but when we got into this, I actually realized that it's pretty much like it should be included in our syllabus as well, into all the branches. So this hackathon like has introduced me to this kind of new concept.
From here, like we started to thinking a bit more about our projects. Like till now we were just concentrated about like achieving our task or accomplishing the deadlines, but not like looking more about like what we are creating or how are we taking this forward as a project and as a team. So yeah, after this hackathon, yeah, we think that we as a team could take many more such projects forward. The thing with Yantra different is the competition based learning part. Like whenever we think Yantra, we also think about learning, right? So there are steps which we go through, like first we learn about things and then we execute them. So basically, this thing about eYantra is very different from other hackathons or from other competitions too. And yeah, the internship thing too. So basically, it is very overwhelming for any student to get internship into IIT Bombay.
Other hackathons, they are basically all focused on the coding side only. So majority of the IT or the CS people participate there. But the difference in eYantra Hackathon was we doing interdisciplinary projects. Like not only implementing this machine learning thing, but we were like given the freedom to do all other things, like build a ventilator or other things that we could explore. So doing interdisciplinary projects is an advantage in eYantra.
When we talk about embedded systems or robotics, so yeah, there is no other competition or no other hackathon which provides such exposure with robotics or with physical hardware.
If you're a person who likes challenges, then this hackathon is for you. You learn many interpersonal skills like time management, teamwork, and planning. Even if you fail, these skills would always come handy to you. Also, these hackathons make some great memories which you will always cherish.